بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
Good evening, Mr. Zakir Naik. I am Kumar from India. I am a Hindu. Past 1.5 years, I am referring Quran. Here, I have some doubts. I should ask you why meditation is not preferable in Islam. And how rebirth is not believable in Islam. I hope there is only one Almighty God. But why He can't create? He is the only one creator. Why He can't create this all humanism? This is a good way and right way.
There are three questions. If I heard you correctly, the first question was, why is meditation not allowed in Islam? Therefore, meditation. The first question was meditation. There were three questions. The first was, why is meditation not allowed in Islam? And the second question that he asked was, that why Almighty God did not create all human beings as good? Why some bad and some good? And the second one, middle one which you asked was rebirth. That why Islam doesn't believe in rebirth. That was the second question. As far as the first part of the question is concerned, that why is meditation not allowed in Islam? Brother, what do you mean by meditation is important? What do you mean by meditation? If you mean by closing your eyes and contemplating, the best form of a direct hotline to God is Salah in Islam. Salah, the prayers. The prayer what we offer is a direct hotline to God. Whether you consider meditation or not, that's a choice of words. The direct hotline to God is Salah. You come in direct in touch with God. But if you think that closing your mind, closing your eyes and keeping your mind empty and meditating, fine. How to meditate? How to reach Almighty God? The best person to say is God Almighty Himself. The best person who can show you how to reach Him is God Himself. So if you read in the Quran, the best part of the Salah, it is sujood. It appears in the Quran no less than 92 times. We put the highest part of the body, the forehead, on the lowest part on the ground, and it's Subhanah bin Allah wa hamd. Glory be to Allah, the most great. Glory be to Allah, the most great. Glory be to Allah, the most great. And today the psychology, they tell us that our body is directly under our control. Our mind is not under our control. Our mind, it keeps on wandering. However much you try, your mind cannot be under your control. Our body is under control. So in order to humble the mind, you have to humble the body. And there's no better way than to put the highest part of the body, the forehead, on the lowest part of the ground, and then say, glory be to Allah, the most high, glory be to Allah, the most high. And this form of worship is even given in your scripture. In the Hindu scripture, there is a worship called as Sashtant, means eight parts. So when you touch the eight parts on the ground, it's called as Sashtant, means eight parts. That is the forehead, that is the nose, two hands, two knees, and two feet. When you do sujood, when you do sajda, we touch our forehead and the nose on the ground, we touch our two hands, we touch both the knees and both the feet. So these eight parts in the Hindu scripture is called as Sashtant, means eight parts. That's the form of worship. If you read the Bible, it's mentioned in Genesis, chapter number 17, verse number 3, that Abraham fell on his face and prayed to God. Book of Numbers, chapter number 20, verse number 6, Moses and Aaron, they fell upon their face and prayed to God. It's mentioned in the book of Joshua, chapter number 5, verse number 14, Joshua fell on his face and prayed to God. If you read the Gospel of Matthew, Jesus, cast peace be upon him, went in the Garden of Gethsemane, took a few steps forward, fell on his face and prayed to God. No gymnast can do better than any Muslims do by falling on the face and praying to God like we do, sajda. The best form of worship is the Salah, and the main part of Salah is the sajda. Regarding details of wudu and standing, everything, if you refer to my cassette on similarities between Islam and Hinduism. I showed more similarities in Salah between Hinduism and Islam. If you see my video cassette, similarity between Islam and Christianity, I showed other similarities about wudu mentioned in the Bible, in the Quran, about praying in the Quran, wudu, taking off your shoes, all these things. It will take long, it's a question answer session. So the best form of hotline to God, it is Salah. If you go to Western countries, there is this new form called as Transcendental Meditation. Transcendental Meditation, a 14 letter word. Transcendental Meditation. And you have to pay through your noses. Our Salah is free. No, now we have yoga in India. You know where you and I come from, yoga. And you have breathing techniques, etc. All these breathing, everything is included in Salah. If you see my talk, Salah, the programming towards righteousness, everything is a package, free package. It benefits you in this world and the year after. Your health benefits. May you do sajda, the abdominal viscera. Today the doctors tell us that when you breathe, only 2/3 of the air is exhaled out and in. 1/3 is called as residual air. Now when you are doing sajda and when you breathe, the abdominal viscera, they press against the diaphragm. And the diaphragm presses against the lower lobes of the lungs. And this 1/3 residual air also comes out. So when you breathe, there's more fresh air coming in. You don't have to do yoga and transcendental meditation and breathing technique. All is inclusive package. The health improves. There is circulation. There is circulation. When you do sujood, when you do sajda, there's increased blood supply to the face. There's less chance of having chilblains, the disease of the face. When you do sujood, there is drainage of the bronchial tree. Less chance of having bronchiectasis. When you do sujood, there is increased venous return of the abdomen. I can go on and on talking about medical benefits. Anyway, these medical benefits of Salah, it is only side dishes. This is not the reason why we pray for medical benefits. There's chance of having chronic backache, and I can go on and on sinusitis. But this is only the sweet side dishes. Our main reason we offer is the hotline to God. It's because to pray to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These side dishes may attract the non-Muslims. Our main course, biryani, it is praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He ordered us and we prayed to him to thank him. These are side dishes, side benefits, but these side benefits are much superior than all your transcendental meditation and yoga. Hope that answers the question, brother.